Vibe with Gemma. This is Dance FM.
What a way to start our day. Here with me is none other than YouTube megastar, English singer and record producer, Connor Maynard. Hello.
What's up? Wow. I think I've ever had such a cool intro for myself before.
Oh, well, it's all true, right?
And here we have some random guy from England. It's Connor Maynard.
Yeah, you know what? For all I know, you could be.
Yeah, no, exactly, yeah. The good thing is me and my brother actually have exactly the same voice over the phone, so sometimes I'll just get him to do... It is actually me, by the way, right now. It is Connor. But... sometimes I would get him to do interviews for me over the phone if I wasn't well or something.
Now I know your trick. You're so sneaky.
It works pretty well.
You are joining us in Dubai to hit up and perform at our brand new super club, Gotta. How do you feel about that?
Yeah, it's gonna be sick. I literally found out the other day that my boy William Singh is gonna be doing it with me, which is gonna be amazing. That should be really, really cool. I didn't realise that he was also performing, so that's gonna be. But yeah, no, I'm really, really excited. I come to Dubai at least once a year normally, and every time it's so much fun. So I'm definitely very excited to get back over there.
Now, it actually wasn't long ago you were in the UAE. Just in December, you were checking out some of Dubai's most luxe cars. Now, no doubt you were spoiled for choice. Is that on the agenda for this trip? And what else have you got planned?
Well, the cool thing was, I normally find out that I'm coming to Dubai through people I know in Dubai, seeing that it's been announced I'm coming before I've even been told that I'm going. So normally, sometimes I won't even get told. My management haven't told me yet, or it hasn't been completely confirmed yet. So then they'll kind of also, let me know if you need any cars and that we're out here. It's really funny though, because obviously on my Instagram, I kind of put up the pictures of me with those kind of cool cars, but behind the scenes, no one realised I actually got the G-Wagon. I got it stuck in the sand in the desert.
Oh, really? You got bogged?
This passing family helped us get the car out of the sand. It was hilarious. We were stuck there for 3 hours.
So this time round, you plan to avoid the sand dunes then?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like the reality was a lot less glamorous than how I portrayed it on Instagram. We were actually stuck in the desert for 3 hours with a car and we couldn't move. That's fun.
Well, you got a real taste of desert life then.
I know, exactly. It's annoying because there's five of us and it's annoying that I was the one that got stuck in the sand. That kind of stuff. I wouldn't mind if it was someone else, but it was me.
Oh, everyone else was fine, just you were the one stuck.
Yeah, literally.
Okay. Right there. Oh, well, I'm not going in your car then. You don't know how to drive.
No, yeah, that's fine. I don't blame you.
You were just 19 when you rocketed to fame after being spotted by Neo on YouTube. How much has your life changed since those early days of your music career?
Yeah, I mean, it's been insane. I grew up in Brighton, which is, a relatively small town in the UK. I think it's probably definitely a lot more prosperous than it was a few years back. But, at least when I was growing up, it was considered quite a small town in the UK. And I think that, I moved to London when I was 18 and I started recording my first album, and I live in LA now. So it's been nuts. It's kind of all changed so fast. For me, the main thing of trying to keep it normal is you kind of just keep your friends around that were there from the very beginning, friends from school, friends from, a young age, and just kind of, I like to keep them kind of close to me at all times, and it makes it feel a little bit more real that it's okay, cool, all this crazy stuff is happening, that's great, but, you've still got your true friends and your real circle around you all the time, so yeah.
Yeah, I imagine that is really important and to keep you grounded, but I'm pretty sure your brother and sister do that as well.
Yeah, exactly. I feel like the good thing about my friends and my family, whatever haters or people that aren't a fan of myself come out with, my friends and family will say things that are 10 times worse. to me. I think they're my harshest critics by far is my friends and family. So.
Oh wow, yeah. Connor, you're brutally honest. Are they listening?
Yeah. Kind of hope not, but yeah, hi Mom.
The Vibe with Gemma. This is Dance FM.
And we are back chatting with Connor Maynard on Dance FM. So, it seems you enjoy a little friendly competition with your sing-off contest, and so do your fans. Yeah. Your sing-off against Pixie Lott, it alone tallied over 114 million YouTube views. So I must ask, who are you eyeing off as your next target to go up against?
I'm not entirely sure. I've had a lot of discussions with different people over doing doing ones. I know that the Vamps, obviously I've done one with them already, and they're ready for round two, so that's in discussion. I feel like I'm talking about like a boxing match.
I know. I love how you said round two. You got the gloves on.
Exactly, yeah. Lily Allen tweeted me recently asking, you know, well, she tweeted me saying that she really loved the last one with my little sister, and I tweeted her back saying, all right, well, let's do the next one, and she seems up for it. I was talking to Ansel Elgort from Baby Driver.
I love him, yes.
Yeah, we were talking about potentially doing one, so if we can make that happen, that would be amazing.
But, I've got an idea. Can I pitch something to you?
Go ahead.
What if you did teams? So you and Ansel versus Anna, your sister, and Lily Allen. Bring it on.
That would be awesome. The thing is, I wanna make it like, I wanna do that. I wanna keep like making it bigger and making it more exciting each time, and just, you know, keep like upping the ante. So I'm ready to do a big old battle. Because I was even starting to think that, what if I started just start hosting them, and I can have them on my YouTube channel, but like I'm not in them, like, I'll just kind of be the ref, and then I feel like I would just get too carried away and I end up just joining in and singing with them and it's ruined the whole thing. So,
yeah, no, you've definitely got to be part of it.
Yeah, exactly.
But a word of warning, I think Lily Allen would be fierce. I think you've met your match there.
Yeah, no, I'd be nervous. I'd be nervous taking a room. I remember when she first kind of started and I was still at school and I remember thinking she was amazing, and yeah, I was quite a fan, so it would be quite interesting to do one against her.
There's no denying covers are your thing. You smash every track you put your voice to, but there is a rumour you're planning a new album of original music. How true is this?
Yeah, it's very true. I've been working on original material for the last, I don't know how long, like 4 or 5 years, and just kind of trying to make it all, you know, exactly how I want to sound and you know, portray the artist that, you know, I want to portray. And I think that, you know, that takes a lot of time to get it just right. And obviously, I've been doing the remixes and covers in the meantime, you know, allow the fans to have something to listen to while I work on the original material behind the scenes. But yeah, there's definitely original material coming out very, very soon.
I'll just rewind, Connor. So you mentioned you had the sing-off with your little sister Anna, and I have to ask, I know it's a touchy topic, but is she still your mum's favourite?
I don't know. I think so. I think she's my mum and dad's favourite, which is even worse.
Whoa, double whammy. Oh, she is a star child.
No, exactly. So yeah, no, she's the girl. Her nickname growing up was the Golden Child. That's literally what they called her. They didn't even try and hide it. Yeah, no, she's the youngest. Jack's the middle, and I'm the oldest.
Now, when you take to the stage at Dubai's newest and hottest superclub, Gotta, this Friday night, March 30, you did mention earlier William Singe is going to be joining you. What have you guys got in store for us?
It's just going to be a party. I think that, you know, I think we're going to definitely put on the most exciting show we can. And I think when you kind of do these kind of shows, especially opening of like a big club or, you know, a new exciting venue, you kind of want to definitely bring the most excitement you possibly can and get everyone dancing and singing along, all that stuff. That's the plan with that.
Connor, no complaints. No one is going to say no to a party. It is going to be wild. All of us at Dance FM cannot wait to see you and William Singe perform at Gotta. Thank you so much for joining me, Connor Maynard.
Thank you for having me. Thank you. I look forward to it.
It's Gemma, and you're listening to The Vibe on 97.8 Dance FM.